Because even the brother who I was running with the dope, he was smoking his dope in a pipe. And he would tell me, sitting there, he'd tell me, say, Dwight, whatever you do, do not hit this pipe. Do not hit it. And I'm seeing him tweaking, picking the stuff off the floor and everything. And he said, bro, do whatever you do, do not hit this pipe. I see that was God's hand right there, because he was doing a whole bunch of different things. You know, I was a functioning addict. I'll go to work, pay my bills, everything. But after I take care of that, whatever's left over is mine. I was on crack and my wife didn't even know it. I had times when I didn't smoke this stuff and blood gushing out of my nose, heart beating real fast, thinking I'm going to die. And after it all settled, I'm going to finish smoking my stuff. You know what I'm saying? It was just that kind of craziness. But I thank the Lord that he allowed me to get to 27, and this brother introduced me. He wasn't even a member at Gideon. He was just going there on Monday nights. So when I went there, man, Pastor was ministering on a man in a woman's world. Man, I tell you, boy, that some of the stuff he was saying, well, what caught me was, he used to say, no, go ask your mama. That's what the man would say. No, go ask your mama. So when he would say that, I said, man, that's what my pa telling me now. Go ask your mama. So I had to got to the point where I stopped going to him. I just go ask my mama. You know, so when he said that, that intrigued me and that kept me coming. And then the Lord put a spotlight on me and just read who I was. And I gave my life to the Lord at 27 years old. So now it's been 22 years, you know, that I've been here. And I thank the Lord, and I see how his hand was on me even to keep me coming here, you know, because when Pastor was there and he said that he was leaving, you know, I couldn't get to Gideon at any other service time, only on Monday night. For some reason, I just could not make any desire to. It was job or whatever that stopped me, but just that Monday night is the only time I can get there for about 6 months. And when Pastor said that he was leaving and he didn't know where he was going or anything, all I know in my spirit was to follow. And I'm like, but he don't know where he going. You know, just follow. And I kid you not, that was that Monday night. I was working the job. That Friday, Elder William ran into me. I was on the job. And he was the one that told me, hey, bro, we have a men's Bible study uptown. And that's how I was able to get there. So I see the Lord, how he just kept me going to stay, to follow. So, I thank him, because without that, I didn't have anyone to, even though my dad was in the home, to even say certain things, to what to look out for, you know, being a man in the men's Bible study, and then getting together with some of the brothers. We used to meet by Brother Ralph's house, man. I enjoyed that. You know what I'm saying? We'll just kick stuff, man. I'm having problems with this and that and the other, and we're just talking, you know, and it was, I never had that before, because I always desired to have, wanted a big brother in the home, because I was the oldest, and everybody ran to me, so that means I'm figuring stuff out. My mom encouraged me to figure, oh, Dwight, he'll figure it out, you know, but I always wanted to go and talk to somebody, you know what I'm saying, man, because I felt the weight of that. But to have these brothers, man, that was hurting just like me in some regard, you know, and give me avenue or what scripture that helped them. And, you know, that was awesome, man. I tell you, God is something. And I'm starting, even at this age, being 22 years in it, you know, I'm learning that, you know, God really, he really loves us. He really loves me. I'm going to make it personal. He really loves me, because I was brought up where you had to do performance. Like Pastor talked about that performance love, you do for me, you think, when you do good, everybody praise you, but as soon as you do wrong. But see, what I did was, I tried to do good so I won't be looked upon as a bad person, right? But I did my dirt though. I was just slick and sneaking, conniving with it. I didn't want to bring shame to my family.